What's happening, everybody in the VC? Craig, your favorite VC rambler, back at you with finally doing some recent finds. It's gonna be a fun one. What do we got here? We got a stack of about 50 or so records here, all a dollar a piece. Give you a quick backstory on this. Craigslist. Sometimes it pans out. I went on those about a month-ish, roughly now, ago. Obviously did the usual search, looking for stuff. Found somebody selling records that said they had about 20,000, all at a dollar a piece. You know, they had 45, 78s, the full kit. I'm like, all right, I'll give it a shot. Sometimes you wonder, are they full of shit? Are they, you know, who knows? So I show up, which by the way, it started at 8 a.m. I showed up late because my ass decided to follow the map that was on Craigslist and not do a proper, just Google Maps search and figure out exactly where I needed to be, like an idiot. That's why you don't let your dogs in the video. So, and if I would have read the description, I would have known exactly where it was at because it's not too far from where I work. Either way, fully admit I'm a dumbass, but guess what? Got it figured out. Showed up about 10 minutes after it opened, which I figured by that point, I'm like, when somebody says over 20,000 records and they're all at a dollar a piece, I'm figuring it's going to be like vultures. Everybody's going to be there. I'm going to miss out on everything. I'm screwed. Been there, done that. Hate early birds. Fucking assholes. Hate getting up early in the morning anyways. But decided, I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna let it be what it is. I'm gonna show up. Hopefully I don't lose anything. And if I do, whatever. Just go with the flow. I get there, and there was only two other people. There was a couple, an older, assuming husband and wife, and a guy who was probably sort of in my age range. That was it. I was really surprised. I'm like, this many records, and it's a beautiful day, and there's only a couple people here? All right, I'm in for a treat. And I was. Definitely was one of those digs that you have to talk about. It was, I didn't know what to expect, whether it was going to be in a large room, you know, whatever it was. It was set up in an industrial park. Sort of-ish, where there's like somebody runs an antique shop in one of the buildings. All the records were in a semi-trailer, like one of the 18-wheeler semis. And they were lined up on each side, you know, of the walls, like on these tables, but in like record, like the wooden, like a record store sort of feel, so you'd be able to flip through everything. A lot of stuff in boxes and rubber containers underneath the tables, and some boxes stacked up on top of each other at the, you'd call it the front, but you know, the back, basically, of the trailer. So you had to do some weird finagling to get to these boxes and move some shit out. And nothing was arranged in any order, so you had no idea. You could be flipping through and find Barbra Streisand, fucking Herb Alpert, Tennessee or Ernie Ford, you think you're digging at a fucking Goodwill, and then all of a sudden you come across, you know, an AC/DC album. You're like, what the fuck? It was very odd, but lots of great finds, and at a dollar piece, I'm very satisfied with what I found. Some really cool kind of hole fillers, some blind buys, but not really, because I know what the bands sound like, and then just some really cool kind of interesting stuff in there, too, that I definitely wouldn't want to pick up for more than a couple bucks just because either it's not worth a huge amount to many or it's just ridiculously overpriced. So, let's dig into these. Enough of me babbling. BC Cheer. Live's debut album, Mental Jewelry, on in the background. This is a recent reissue. I don't know if we got a proper vinyl pressing the first time around. Either way, just came out. This is the black vinyl version. I didn't spring for the colored vinyl. Overall, fairly satisfied. I mean, Maybe I'm just used to listening to it on CD for the past 20 plus years. So anyway, let's get into these. We'll start right off with a bang. Like I said, these are dollar piece. I mean, you ran the range of finding some maybe cool near mint stuff all the way to absolute shit. You know, you could find a Grail album that you've been looking for forever and it's just fucking roached. David Michael. Thought of you on that one. But this one, the cover is definitely seen better days, but the vinyl is in beautiful shape and I couldn't leave it for a dollar.
Okay.
Mo-fi pressing of Pat Benatar's debut album, In the Heat of the Night. This is, like I said, this cover is absolutely, you can see it's torched, but vinyl is in pristine shape, and you just don't leave Mo-fi behind for a buck. I sure as hell wasn't going to, and I mean, you're not playing the cover, so well worth it for me. And that, by the way, is a great album. My own. Why the hell I need a third copy of this album on vinyl is beyond me. I have two other pressings, and it's not my favorite Pat Benatar, but God, after listening to it on Mo-Fi, it's definitely up there now. Moving on here, more albums that I don't need more copies of. Styx, Pieces of Eight. I've got a beautiful copy already that I've had for years, but why do you need another copy? Oh, because this one's pressed on gold vinyl. I believe this is Canadian press, yep, pressed in Canada. And I mean, for a buck, I couldn't leave it behind. It's a great album. I do love Styx, and I enjoy this album greatly. Next, crazy stack. So obviously when you're digging through, when they weren't bullshitting when they said 20,000 records, there was a shitload. And like I said, you've dug through a lot of just shitty stuff to find the really cool things. And these I found on the first, actually I forgot to preface this, I went two different times. So I went one weekend on a Saturday morning and then I went 2 weeks later again when they did it. Both times I was crunched for time. But I managed to find a lot of stuff, obviously. These ones I found right before I left on the first dig. I go with your gut sometimes. You see something kind of cool sitting on top of something, you're like, ah, we'll investigate. Pulled out a box and I found all of these right in a row, along with the one I'm going to show after this little stack from the same artist. I'm not the world's biggest Elvis fan. I am a fan. I like stuff. His Sun and pre-Army RCA period are my favorite. I don't go seeking all this stuff out. If I find it for cheap, like I did here, I'll grab it. And in beautiful shape, too. These are all in awesome shape, and I couldn't pass them up. So, on stage, February 1970. And I will say, I have not listened to all of these yet. I haven't even gotten to clean them all. I'm just so backlogged. But, it was great to find these. His Hand in Mine, very cool. So I'm sure I could be showing a record here that I haven't cleaned yet and I haven't spun and find out like it's warped or some shit. The Sun Years, this is kind of like just interviews and excerpts and stuff like that. So this is pretty cool. I definitely wouldn't have sprung on it if it weren't for a buck. Moody Blue. This is the blue vinyl pressing. 50,000 Elvis fans can't be wrong. If you've been following my channel since the beginning, I actually picked up a copy of this in the dollar bin about 5 years ago and traded it off sometime later. Just because I traded off a handful of Elvis records for an XTC album, which was fucking worth it. I already have a copy of this, but Elvis's second full-length album. Great early stuff. I'm not sure if this one's in better shape than my other copy or not, but hey. And this is Volume 2, Legendary Performer. Figure why the hell that was for a buck. Sometimes you see these pretty frequently around here locally, and they're usually a few bucks, but I don't see the point in needing to pick them up. You know, I'm probably not going to listen to them much at all, but for a buck, still in the shrink, beautiful shape, why not? This one was a really, really cool find, and not necessarily something that I needed, but for a buck, you're not gonna pass it up. Beatles, 20 greatest hits. What really needs to be said? This is just, you know, compilation, greatest hits. For a buck, I'm not gonna leave it. Do I need this? No, I've got pretty much everything Beatles related that I need. Say that, but then there's so much I want. But for a buck, this is a great addition to the collection. I already have it on cassette, so I know if I'm ever in a Beatles mood, this would be nice to just throw on in the background and move on with your day. A little bit of country for, I'm not a big country guy, but I've been wanting this one for a while. Merle Haggard, Mama Tried. This one has definitely been on the want list for a while, and I was trying to seek out a copy before he passed away, and then once he passed away, then all copies, trashed or in beautiful shape, went fucking through the roof, and I decided, nope. And I ran across one copy in the wild, and it was just not in the greatest of shape, and it went like 10 bucks, I'm like, nope. But this one, if I remember correctly, other than needing a decent cleaning, actually looks really nice. So, definitely looking forward to spinning that one. Shout out to Jim and the Misses, Memphis Vinyl Jim. What's going on, my friend? Thought of you when I picked this one up. David Allen Coe, Long-Haired Redneck. Now, I'm not familiar at all. I know the name. I don't know any of his music whatsoever, but for a buck, I'm willing to give it a shot. Why the hell not? Literally, why the hell not? Okay. School Punks, Brownsville Station. I could not pass this one up. This is a really nice clean copy of this. I think there's anything on here now. But this is one you see pretty frequently, you know, in a lot of your sort of your bargain bins and stuff like that, your local record stores. For a clean copy of this, usually I see this one going for a few bucks, and it's usually a little partied out. So that was really cool to find. Leon Redbone, self-titled. Probably need to take the shrink off. This one's a little dirty, but for a buck, why not? A nice addition to the UFO collection, No Place to Run on Chrysalis. Not a hard one to find, just one I haven't picked up. I pretty much collected what I needed for the 70s and then some of the 80s stuff, mainly, you know, my favorite 80s period UFO mechanics. That's all I really needed from the 80s as far as I was concerned, you know. And post Strangers in the Night, I was like, do I really need anything? Not necessarily, but I'm a big UFO fan regardless, so you gotta have it. So that was really cool to find for a buck. Nice double for me here, but I couldn't leave it. Rat, Invasion of Your Privacy. This was really cool to find. Not my favorite Rat album, I would say. Obviously, Out of the Cellar would definitely be my pick for best cohesive album. It kind of just became a better like singles band after that. Well, this one's got some really cool songs on here. You're in Love, Lay It Down, Never Use Love. I really like that song. Overall, not bad. But like I said, I've already got a beautiful clean copy. So this one, I couldn't leave. I will say I am picking up, I do have a stack of some doubles in here that I picked up, and I will explain why I'm picking up so many doubles lately. Alright, let's move on here. Joe Cocker, with a little help from my friends. Nice, very, very clean copy overall. Could not leave this one behind. This, I've been on the hunt for a copy of this for a long time, so I've got a cassette, but nothing beats having it on vinyl. So I'm very excited to clean this and give this a spin here soon. This one had, if I remember right, it was a little on the iffy side, but I figured for a buck I'll give it a shot. Al Green, Let's Stay Together. Don't have much Al Green. I do have one of his albums. Yeah, that's definitely this seemed better days, but it didn't have anything, no deep marks. It's definitely got a lot of play, but I think it's still got some life left in it after I clean it, so well worth grabbing. One I see pretty often, but usually it's, you know, a few bucks, and it's not on the want list. It's kind of like, if I find it really cheap, I'll grab it. So, finally, for a buck, I'll grab it. West, Bruce, and Lang. So you got Leslie West, Jack Bruce, Corky Lang. Very, very excited to grab this one. Really nice clean copy for cheap. This one, The Birds, the Bees, and the Monkees. My wife is a huge Monkees fan, which has really kind of piqued my interest as the years have gone on. This one, definitely not perfect, but it'll be a good, decent, clean copy to have in the collection until I find a really nice copy, but very cool. The Jackson 5, third album. This has I'll Be There, cover of Bridge Over Troubled Water, Going Back to Indiana. Very cool. Don't see full-length Jackson 5 very often. You see the singles and stuff like that, but you don't see full albums, especially for cheap. So, had to grab it. A couple from the mighty Elton John, Here and There. So this is a live album. So you got one side live in London, one side live in New York. Thank you, Junior Ball. Whatever. I have no idea how to say your name, but thanks for writing your name on the back. So very cool to have that. And a copy of Empty Sky. Did not have this one. You see it pretty frequently, but I've never seen this cover before. So I haven't done my research to see which pressing this was, but cool addition. You know, just kind of round out the Elton John collection for the most part. This was pretty cool. Pete Seeger, Waist Deep in the Big Muddy and Other Love Songs. This is a promo copy. So, always like seeing promos and stuff like that. I believe it's 2i Columbia. Yep. 2i Columbia mono. So very cool. Not a huge Pete Seeger fan, but for a dollar, I'm gonna not leave it behind. Maybe worth my while. This one was really cool. Greatest Hits of the National Lampoon. After watching the National Lampoon documentary that was on, was it Showtime? HBO? I think it was Showtime, because I watched it on Hulu. Definitely got into learning more about National Lampoon and stuff like that beyond the films or the, knowing that obviously Belushi and Chevy Chase and Bill Murray, you know, those guys, Gilda Radner, you know, so many other talents came from the Lampoon. So this is really cool find. Interested to give this one a listen, stuff like that. I'm sure Brother Eli would appreciate this one, so thinking of you, brother. Moving on here, Ringo Starr, Sentimental Journey, his first solo album, very cool, glad to have that one. A couple hole fillers here, Head East, US 1, this is from 1980, no idea what to expect there, and one I see pretty often, Getting Lucky. This one's pretty easy to find, but usually a little partied out or overpriced. I'm sorry. For an album that I don't necessarily need, I'm not spending more than a buck. This one, didn't need it, but well worth grabbing. Crosby, Stills, and Nash, Replay. So kind of a compilation. It's got some re-recordings on here. I think there's at least one, like Carry On. It's got some additional stuff to it and things like that. This was cool, just for a buck and in beautiful shape. I figured might as well add it. Plus, I have it on cassette already, so if I ever decide to get rid of my cassette collection, that's never happening. I'd have another copy. So, next one's up here. We got some doubles. I said I would explain why I'm picking up so many doubles. So, I said that there was kind of some big stuff going on around here, some big changes. Well, besides the fact that I changed jobs a couple years ago, so complete career switch. Okay, so I got another song. My wife and I are also expecting our first child. So we're having a little girl, expecting beginning of December. So I'll pause for gasps. So I've decided to kind of go through all my doubles and pull out some cleaner copies of stuff and start putting together a little sort of record collection for my future daughter. I've got a turntable and speakers and working on getting a receiver together so I have something set up for her. So if she does decide that she, you know, as she gets older, gets into the same kind of hobby that her dad's in, God forbid I'm already going to go broke as it is from my own addiction, she'll have a collection to kind of start her off with. So if she doesn't, hey, I haven't really lost in the deal. But if she does, hey, I've got her on the right path. So so with these, you know, picked up some stuff that was A, very clean, and B, albums that I knew I listened to a lot that she would be accustomed to hearing and would probably enjoy having copies of her own if she likes hearing that stuff. So, Asia's debut, still gonna shrink. Final's got a little bit of love, but still got life in it. Obviously, Fleetwood Mac Rumors, no collection is complete without it. One of my favorite albums of the 80s, and my favorite album from this band, The Fix, Phantoms. Love this album, cannot recommend this album enough. Picked these up actually on the second trip. That was the same day we actually had the gender reveal and found out that we were having a girl. So there was my reason why I had to cut my dating short. The Eagles, Greatest Hits, 71 to 75. So had to pick these up, you know, kind of hoping that if she does get into it, she likes some of the stuff. Whatever music she decides to get into is all her own. I'm not going to influence beyond that. She decides that she wants to be into Gregorian chants. Hey, I'm going to let her. That's what it is. Cheap Trick, In Color. I already have a earlier pressing, of this, but could not pass up a clean copy. It's a later press. So you don't pass up the clean stuff. And no, that one's for me. Elvis recorded live on stage in Memphis. This is the next set of stuff is all the stuff that I found from the second round of digging. Another dollar, you know, obviously, they're all dollar finds. But another one for the Elvis one. I couldn't remember when I was digging the first time around. Well, when I went back for the second time, I remember seeing a decent stack of Elvis stuff that was in the, in the stacks, and could have swore it went past a bunch of his soundtrack albums, and I didn't remember what they looked like in terms of condition, at least with the covers, or if, you know, vinyl was in better shape, I don't know. Either way, I found that in the stack of all of them, but all of those were torched, so I wondered, I was like, why did I leave all those behind? Oh yeah, because they were fucking wrecked. It happens. Time to flip the album over. It's a good time if you gotta use the bathroom. Go. Moving on. Next one here. Really excited to find this, and I can't believe I must have missed it because I remember going through this particular stack. Very cool find. Tom Paxton 6. Nice addition to the Elektra 4000 series that I've talked about previously that I'm collecting. And I will do a video here soon showing all the ones that I've picked up. But this was very, very cool to find. I was super stoked when and definitely needs a major cleaning, but on the red Electra label, very excited to add this. That's probably, I'm not a huge Tom Paxton fan, but that would probably be rated as one of my favorite finds of the entire day. Just getting harder to find some of the titles, especially cheap, because I'm getting into the more expensive stuff. This one, just picked it up because it was in nice shape. The producers, I remember the name from, you know, watching old MTV footage from the early 80s. And this album's from 1981, produced by Tom Werman. So that part I know, and it's on Portrait. So I'll give it a shot. For a buck, why the hell not? This one was a really cool find. With the first album from Big Audio Dynamite. Correct me if I'm wrong, but this is very cool to find from 1985. Definitely a Mick Jones fan here, so I love The Clash. So, very cool to find that. Pretty common one here, but I don't know why I've never had it in the collection. Paul Simon, there goes Rhyming Simon. Definitely would go to Chrome. I guess that would be my big reason for wanting to have this one, but love Paul Simon regardless. Not essential, but for a buck, you're not going to leave it. Johnny Cash and the Tennessee 2 Showtime. And to my knowledge, I'm assuming just another repackaged version of a shitload of, you know, his son stuff. But this is really worth it for me to have, you know, something that I could put on and have Big River, I Walk the Line, Cry Cry Cry, Hey Porter, and Folsom Prison Blues all in the same set. So, very, very cool. Nice addition to the Johnny Cash collection. Another double here. I didn't keep all my doubles together. Steve Miller Band, Greatest Hits, 74 to 78. I'm pretty sure I already have this album. So, but for a buck, and plus I didn't think I had it when I grabbed it, and then I got home and realized, I'm like, I think I already have this. I think I picked it up at Goodwill a couple years ago. Already said, I'm not a big country person. I like some country rock, you know, older stuff. Very, very spotty, and I'm very selective about what I listen to. But for a buck each on these, I had to grab them. I've been wanting to get into these two albums in particular, so to find them for a buck each, couldn't have been happier to find them. Willie Nelson, Redheaded Stranger. Very, very cool to find that, and Stardust. And I had seen probably about half a dozen to maybe 10 copies of this album in varying shapes. When I went back the second time, I made it a point to, if I found a really nice copy, I was going to grab it. Because for a buck, I've heard a lot of good things about this album in particular, so I wanted to go ahead and grab it. Let's see here. Next, Stevie Wonder's Journey Through the Secret Life of Plants. What can I say about this? It's Secret Life of Plants. Either way, Stevie Wonder. Had to grab it. Starting to wind it down here. So, Argent in Deep. Very cool to find this one for a buck. Very excited about that one. Faithful, Todd Rundgren. Very, very cool to find this one. Very hard to find a clean copy of this for cheap. So you definitely see the ring wear and stuff like that on this. But tend to find that a decent amount of Todd Rundgren's stuff ends up being ridiculously overpriced. I mean, for as easily as you can find a lot of his albums, especially at least, you know, between the record shows and some of the record stores that I, you know, happen to go to, you see a lot of Todd Rundgren, and yet it ends up being really pricey, and it just makes no sense to me whatsoever. It's like, these albums sold pretty well. Does it really need to be, like, 15, 20 bucks for this album? This one, it initially threw me off. I thought it was a religious album until I looked and saw who it was. So, Black Oak, Arkansas, Keep the Faith. This one's definitely, God, some of these really need to be cleaned. But this was really cool to find for a buck. I'm glad I looked at it again, because I flipped right past it and went, wait a minute, I recognize that album cover from somewhere, and I realized, holy shit, Black Oak, Arkansas. This one, really cool. Sweet Revenge, John Prine. Cover's definitely seen better days, but the vinyl is in nice shape. So I've been really getting into John Prine. I've picked up a couple of his albums over the last few years, and really, really like his stuff. So this is really cool for a buck. And last, definitely not least, really, really cool to find this. Youngbloods. Is this called Elephant Mountain? Yeah. Just want to make sure. Elephant Mountain. So, very, very cool to find this. I was super stoked on this. I just couldn't believe, some of the stuff that you see, and especially when I grabbed it, when I found it the second go around, it made me wonder how many people are showing up to these sales after I've been there, or, the countless number of other people, what they're passing over. It's kind of like when I look over, it's what other people were finding, and just take a quick glance and see somebody grab, Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young, Deja Vu. Kind of go, all right, cool, so you got some interesting taste, or like, the couple I had seen, they grabbed a crate, I think about 80 records I saw them leaving with, and it's like the first one that I caught that was Moving Pictures by Rush, and I'm like, oh, okay, cool, so they found some interesting stuff, awesome. But then you pass by certain stuff like that, and you go, where your tastes vary, are you strictly on the mainstream, or are you looking for oddities? I don't know, I was looking for just anything. But I found some really cool stuff. I'm very happy with all my finds. I'm glad I finally took the time out to share it with you guys. So that is it for the dollar finds. Just felt great to get some dollar finds. You don't get much bargain bin hunting anymore these days. I do a lot of my shopping online anymore, and just very, very glad to be able to come home with a huge stack of dollar finds. Takes me back to the days when I first started doing these videos 5 years ago. 5.5 years ago, Jesus. Wow, back when the dollar bins were fruitful. Anywho, that'll do it for this vinyl update. I have lots more I need to share with you guys. Quick shout outs. I am watching videos, just not able to comment as much, guys, so sorry for the lame excuse. But, shouts out to Bo, Earhead 6, still watching your videos, loving the stuff. Mark Ditch, Glass Orchid Aftermath, if you're not watching his videos, get on over there. He's back, and he's been at it for a couple months and doing some great stuff, showing some interesting stuff. Glad to see you back, Mark. Obviously, Jim the Misses, glad to see you guys back. Eli, thanks for the shout out in your recent video. Love you, brother. Corey, still watching your videos and loving your stuff too, brother. Brino, Aaron, the Metal Theologian, Robin Boston, that pretty much does it. I'm spacing out. Everybody else, my friends, my family out there, you guys know I love you, and if I missed you, you know I'm thinking about you. So, until the next video, you guys take care, and I'll see you soon. Peace.